Welcome. My name is Jorge Gavillan. I'm the instructor. What I want to do is I just want to show you how to do part one of the project. So I'm going to kind of go through a few things where you can find the information, and then also just kind of hopefully address any concerns that you might have. So the first thing is there is an introduction video. And I do apologize. I noticed that it wasn't published, so I did publish it. It just has some useful information for you to be able to continue to work successfully in the course. The next thing is if you go into modules, you're going to notice that there's a module called project. And so the one that you want to click on, sorry, that's my dog. The one that you want to click on is the online project. When you click on that, you're going to get a Word document, and the Word document is going to look like this. And then, so here I have part one. Now, it's not due October 28th, it's actually due September, August 28th. So I'm going to take that off so I don't confuse anybody, and I do apologize for that. So what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to find a poll that's been administered by a legitimate polling place. And so you cannot use a poll from CNN or MSNBC or Fox News or, you know, Newsweek or New York Times or anything like that. It has to be a legitimate polling place. And I did provide a few websites that have polling places that or polling organizations that are actually legitimate and they are unbiased. And I also provided a wiki page or link that will also have even more. I just provided a few of them. Now, the instructions say that you're going to search, you know, for a poll. If you have a specific topic that you're interested in, you can many times go to these pages, type in a search, and if they have conducted a poll on that topic, it should come up, and so you should be able to use that. Now, when you find your poll, after you've gone through Gallup or Pew or Reuters or some of the other ones, what you want to do is you're going to copy 3 to 6 questions from the poll. And when you choose them, you're going to have to send me that. So that your part one is basically you sending me the link to the poll, sending me the questions that you want to copy, and then I'll just get back to you and say, hey, you're good to go. Go ahead and get started. So the next video after this, I'm going to show you how to put the survey together using Google Forms so you can go ahead and administer that your poll. Now, when you choose all these things and you start creating your poll before you do, you know, part two, these questions here, age, gender, race, ethnicity, level of education, and income level, they're not optional. You have to ask those questions in addition to the 3 to 6 questions that you're going to copy. When you copy the questions, you cannot change any of the responses. And so, I'm gonna show you an example. I think it's a Pew Research poll. And I'm gonna show you, you know, if you like the question, you can choose the question. But if they ask, if the response choices are yes, no, or I don't know, when you administer that, you have to use exactly the same answer choices. And the reason being is that these questions for these polls have been validated. They're reliable. And if we change them, we might not quite measure what we want to measure, right? Or what we think we're measuring. So we need valid and reliable questions. And so that's part one. Find a poll that you like, you know, choose the topic. Pick 3 to 6 questions, and then submit that to me for the Dropbox. It could be a Word document just with the link, the questions that you're going to copy. I prefer that you give me the full question with the response choices from the original poll. And also, I'm going to show you in Pew Research, they have a document called the Top Line, where it has the results that they got when they administered the poll. And you're going to need that information because when we get to part six or part five, you're going to do hypothesis testing with you're going to compare your results to the results that the national poll got. So you need that information. So make sure that you also give me that. So basically, that's what you're going to do. You're going to look through these. You're going to find a topic that you want. Choose 3 to 6 questions. When you start building your poll, you have to ask these questions. They're not optional. Sometimes some students would like to ask religious identification questions or political identification questions, and that's fine. What I prefer is that you find a poll that asks that question. That way you can copy exactly the way that they wrote their question with their response choices. And so that way, you know, you're measuring what you really want to measure and not something else. So if you go to Pew, and I'm going to show you here, let me go here. You're going to notice that I chose this example, right? Trust and distrust in America. And so if I go through what they provided, I can see the results that they got for some of the questions that they asked, right? So Americans think that distrust of federal government and each other is a problem that gets in the way of solving issues. And so the percent of U.S. adults who believe, and then you got the results. Now, it's really important that you understand that when you're really looking for proportions, right? So they got 75% that said federal government. If you administer this particular question, you might get 60%. You might get 80%. And that's okay because it's a sample and it's different than what this polling place did. And that's when we compare it for the hypothesis testing to see if your results match what they got, right? And so if you go through them, again, you're going to see, and some of these, you know, if the reason I want you to pick your own topic is because this is your baby, right? And so you go through them and you see all the different questions. Now, once you decide, yes, I like this and I want to see the questions, Pew Research Center actually makes it really easy to find the questions, perhaps more than some of the other ones. So if you click on the top line here, what you're going to get is you're going to get this document. And so this document just basically tells you when was the poll administered, what was the sample size, and then the questions. And then so here, this is the trust or distrust poll. So they would say, generally speaking, you would say that most people can be trusted. 52% of the participants answered most people can be trusted. 47% said most can't be trusted, and then 1% said no answer. So these values are actually percentages. They're not raw numbers, okay? And so it makes it easy when, if I copy this question, when I do my hypothesis testing, I can just compare my proportion, my results to these results, right? And you can see that you can go through them and then you can get all of the different questions. Now, you're going to have to spend some time looking at these because sometimes the question just doesn't pop out at you and you're going to have to say, okay, is this the question? Are these the responses? So you're going to have to do that. And just go through them. Pew, again, is probably the best one because they provide the top line right there. Gallup, although they have some really good polls, they make it really difficult to find the questions and you really have to dig. Plus, you have to sort of sign in. Let me show you. So I have to, if I, this is Gallup, right? And if I click on this one, I think a lot of times what it does, it'll ask me to sign in, right? And so this is actually the poll for this one. I think the cookies on my computer are set to this thing. Let me open up this document so you guys can see it real quick. And so this tells you, you know, the same thing that we saw in Pew, but in Pew, it was right there on the site and we didn't have to download anything other than the top line to get the questions. So what happens with Gallup is that you really have to go through this entire document to sort of find the actual question. And sometimes you might run into some problems and you say, hey, I'm not sure exactly where the questions are. And that's when you're welcome to reach out to me and I can help you find the actual question that they asked for the poll, okay? And so again, Pew Research kind of makes it easy. They give the complete report, but the top line is really what you want. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna post videos on a weekly basis, and so hopefully I'll answer the questions that you might have. Use the FAQ discussion board to post any questions, and I'll look at that. I'll try to look at it every day. Sometimes I might miss a day, but I'm here to help you, and I'll post as many videos and as you know answer any questions that you might have, so you can complete this thing successfully. Thank you.